It should be Julian giving this talk, as he's our chairman. But everyone said, seeing as he's already giving a talk, no one could bear him talking twice. And when I was told I had to do it, I mean, when I volunteered, I said, there's no way I can talk for half an hour on NAS. And then this morning, when I got to 130 slides for a 30-minute session, I thought, oh dear. So, are you ready? It's going to be very quick. So, I was hoping someone was going to talk about Nottingham and Nottinghamshire in general when you're all here, because we've got football and cricket and what else do we have? Melton Mowbray pies.
Cheese.
So there's lots of good things about this area. There are some famous astronomers which either were born or lived in Nottinghamshire. John Russell Hind, Edward Lowe. The Lowe family were a big Nottingham family who were interested in all sorts of natural sciences. And they had an observatory in Beeston, which was originally a meteorological one, but he became more interested in astronomy, so they had meteor watches and things. And then William Sadler Franks was born near Newark, and he's a chap I'm interested in. He's the chap who took Patrick Moore under his wing when Patrick was young. So he's a fascinating chap. And there's a brilliant paper in The Antiquarian Astronomer by Madeline Cox, who's unfortunately no longer with us. That's available online if you want to have a read about various Nottinghamshire astronomers. So we're a charitable incorporated organisation. It's a bit like a charity, but I'm not sure of the actual differences. And on our manifesto, we've got this sort of statement to advance public interest and education in the science and of astronomy and related subjects. So that's our sort of aims. Now, the history of our society has been written up by myself and Brian Griffin, who's a very long-standing member of the society. And this again is available online. It's in the Society for the History of Astronomy bulletin. And I've picked out bits of that today. The first mention of a society for astronomy in Nottingham is from the English Mechanic from 1921. There's a group that met at the Old Mechanics Institute, and this is the first mention of any society. Not sure how long this one lasted for, can't really find much more about it in the literature. Come in, if you're meant to be here. The first mention of the current incarnation of the society is a contribution to the BAA journal from 1951, written by Mr. A.J. Ashmore. And he says that he had the idea for a society in 1938 and found some interested parties, but then the war happened, so that was all put on hold. But after the war, he gathered the individuals who were still remaining, and they had their inaugural meeting in May 1946, and they got 60 attendees, which I think is quite impressive. And again, the modern society, we've had some big names from the history of British astronomy and also members of the BAA. Initially, the society predominantly had meetings, indoor meetings, once a month with either invited speakers or a member of the society. This is a picture from 1961 of a young Patrick Moore, Lane Hall, and apparently this is Miss Mott. She looks a bit formidable, but she appears in lots of photos and archives, and people who remember her say she was a very warm and friendly lady. We've continued to hold the monthly meeting theme once a month with a sort of, we call it the formal meeting, where we have an invited speaker. So you recognise various people here. And then Although I joined the society, I think in 2012, when I finally settled in Nottingham, sort of 2015, 2016 is when I started to get more involved, and we felt we should have a meeting that was more geared towards practical astronomy, not just an astrophysicist coming to tell us about things which half the audience don't understand. And so we started a second monthly meeting, and I rapidly had to think of a name, so I called it Social and Practical Astronomy, and it stuck. I'm not sure it's a great name, but that's what it is.
Well, it's social and it's practical.
Well, that's it.
Astronomy.
Yeah. It's a good name. So we meet in a village hall, and yeah, this is Lee, and he's showing off a refractor, and I don't know what he's talking about there, but this is a sort of numbers of attendance we get at those meetings, and we have all different styles of event. We had one on astronomy gadgets where we asked people to just bring an astronomy gadget in and talk about it, and that was good fun. Barry Chatsfield, who some of you will know, bought in a blanket. he's a bit eccentric. But he uses this for solar observing. So he puts his face to the eyepiece and then squirrels away under a blanket. So that was his astronomy gadget, and it really is a good idea. We have lots of cake. Chris will be cringing because there's a picture of her. We made a comet. Well, Julian made a comet. That was good fun. I tried to get the video, but it doesn't play very well. So here's Julian adding the dry ice, the final element. And it really stunk. It had ammonia and vinegar and soy sauce and soil. Yeah. And we had. Yeah, it had soy sauce. It needed organic materials. The Environment Agency were going to try and shut us down because this thing was vaping off and stinking, and I think it lasted for about 3 months in Julian's garden. We also have these sessions where we break the whole group up into groups of 3, 4, or 5, and each of the groups talks about something different with a chairperson. And this is one event where we've got this cheap orrery. It just, the planets just go round the sun in a random time. And we set up, the sun lights up, and Julian set up a web camera, and there's some free software, and you can actually measure a transit of this planet on the orrery around the sun, and show the sort of things we saw earlier on. Julian also works at the university, so we have good links with both universities in Nottingham, and we've had some of the PhD students come and talk to us about their projects, which is good for them and interesting for us. And then the most recent talk we had, Mark, where's Mark? He brought his EV scope along and gave us a really good talk about that last week. So if you want to know anything about EV scope, Mark or Micah here. What's that? Yeah, coronavirus. So coronavirus kicked in and we went online. Richard did most of the work. Wave your hand, Richard.
Second job.
it was a second job. So we did both meetings online, and they all went onto YouTube, and they're still there to watch. We have had a journal since we've been in existence, and this is number 5. This is unfortunately the earliest one we've got, and they're talking about the bad weather. So nothing changes. So observing, this is another crucial part of any astronomical society. Initially it was all done in back gardens, and then in the 50s and 60s, they put this concrete plinth in the garden of Gedling House and could drag a telescope out and observe there. But 60s, 70s, they were thinking they'd like to have an observatory. Obviously, none of us were around at this time, so they did some research, and this is Nottingham in the red circle, and you can see the Trent Valley here, so the River Trent's coming along and up there to the Humber, and Nottingham sits in that, and you can really see this contour map. I think this is a brilliant website. You can see the Trent Valley, and that's Nottingham. And so the city's here, so we wanted somewhere high with a clear southern horizon, and I can't see from this point. So, yeah, Cotgrave, this is where they chose this a target site to search, and they found that Severn Trent had a water reservoir there, high up, and they negotiated with them. Here you can see it's to the southeast of the city, and this is the observatory site, modern day satellite image. Well, and this is the village town of Cotgrave, and they negotiated with Severn Trent, and I think the rent was £1 a year for a 99 year lease, and have we paid it all now?
We have,
yeah. One of the treasurers paid it all off in one go, so we haven't got to send £1 check every year. And then these guys did an amazing job of building an observatory. Thinking about the roof, they thought about a silo, so they travelled a long way and took a silo lid off and lugged it back. And this is just a few snapshots, thanks to this chap, Brian Griffin, who archived all these pictures. And they bent all the girders by hand with this tool. And then the observatory took shape. And then in 1984, they lowered the roof on. And here you can see inside the observatory now, there's a girder which goes all the way around, and it sits on wheels on these axles. And because all the girders were bent by hand, it's not very circular. So there's various sticking bits, which we'll show David tomorrow, and anyone else who wants to come. They left a hole for a pier, and that's isolated from the rest of the floor. And in 1991, it pretty completed. Then there was a bit of a hiatus, and then 1998, they put the slit in. And early 2000s, installed after much discussion and fallout, a 24-inch reflecting scope, F4, on a fork equatorial mount. And then the opening event was 2006. Here's Fred. Fred, put your hand up. Then chairman, and Mike Merrifield, who was recently head of school here in astronomy and physics. I don't think, oh, Mike's here as well. There's Mike, our current treasurer. I think that's it.
Hang on, the designer,
yeah.
David Lucullus,
oh, yeah.
Famous telescope maker,
yeah.
In Nottingham. He designed it. You can see he's looking very glum. I think when he got the results, he found out why.
So we jumped from the opening 06 to the 70th birthday party 2016. The scope never got a great deal of use for whatever reason, whether it, as everyone knows, observatories take an enormous amount of time and effort to look after, and they depend on a limited number of people to open up and use, and so that scope never got a great deal of use. And again, this is a 2015-2016 time, thinking about what can we do to improve things. And we made some changes, and hopefully this video will play. So Richard's got a drone, and he has got his drone license. So this is the observatory last summer. So you can see it's inside this compound of a reservoir, and it's on the edge of a farm. And the boundary of our area is really the hedge. If you could square that off, that's our bit of land. We've since reinstalled a wind turbine on that pole, and you might see there's some solar panels as well which power the batteries. So we've taken the 24-inch out, and we've now got an EQ8 mount and a C14, and that's an 80mm refractor on the top. And I'm planning to stick a solar scope on it as well. I haven't told anyone this. Yeah. I was thinking we could put the solar scope underneath. I don't know if that would work, but we'll have a go. We'll show David tomorrow. So this is the current setup. I think I'm not sure it shows much more, but it's nice to have drone footage. This is the panorama of the site. It's a 360 view, and in fact, there we go, there's south, pointing at the Portaloo, which we've recently bought, because it's very remote. There's no electricity, no water, hardly any astronomy. The city is over here, so the sort of dome of light pollution is there. But that means we've got good sort of southwest, south, and east round to north. The Vale of Bever is over there, spelt Belvoir. I don't know if anyone says Belvoir, but it's pronounced Bever. And from the site, it's relatively dark. We've captured noctilucent clouds and various other things, transit of Mercury, Mars, a Galilean moon, ring nebula. Nick?
That being Neil Weiss, presumably, was it?
Yeah, well done. more well done that you got it from the image. and then the sun. Outreach, we've moved our main meeting venue to the Nottingham Emmanuel School, and Mike, our treasurer, is sorting us. He's dropped us in it and said we'll teach the students about telescopes. I have actually got the A-level book now, and it's frightening.
Yes, it arrived this morning, so we can sit and read it out.
What have you got us into? We've often attended village shows with stands, and we've supported other events, and Julian gets contacted by the media for things now and then. And then, of course, Alan Heath, if you get the BAA journal, you'll see there's an interview with him for the June edition. Alan joined Nottingham Astronomical Society, and I think in about 52, and he was the chairman soon afterwards, and former Saturn section director for about 29 years of the BAA. And Alan lives nearby, and he's got caring responsibilities, but we try and get him to events. It's great to have Alan. And then this is the solar graph. I processed it yesterday. So you can just see the observatory. This is looking from the north-south. And you can see the observatory and the hedge and some sun. So that's hot off the press. No one's seen that except me. It's the first one from the observatory we've done. And that's not our observatory on our logo. I think it's Mount Wilson. And I keep meaning we probably need to design our own logo now, which hasn't got the Mount Wilson Observatory on. So that's it. That was a whistle top store, whatever, through Nottingham Astronomical Society.